Did you miss this month's art studio? Here's a short tutorial on the project we did. For this work of art, you will need a piece of paper, a pencil, a Sharpie or black marker, a ruler or straight edge, some crayons, markers, or coloring material of your choice. First, you will use your pencil to draw three C-shaped hills at the bottom of your sheet. Then, between those hills, you'll draw three smaller hills. Then you'll draw one big heart in the middle of your sheet. Next, you will create an arch of hearts surrounding your large heart. This will take 7 hearts total. Don't worry about having the hearts be perfect or all at the same angle. You can always go back and change them before we go over it with our black Sharpie. Now, we're going to divide our sheet into separate sections. Each section will have its own pattern, which will create that Romero Britto style. Some of the lines will be straight, and for those, you can use your ruler or straight edge. Some of them will be curved. It's really up to you. In order to make sure that the lines ended up crossing at the points I wanted them to, I made little dots on the different hearts and made my lines across those dots. You'll see that in some cases, the lines go through the hearts, and in some cases, they don't. This is entirely up to you. I used 5 lines to separate my work into 6 sections. Feel free to use as many as you like. Once you're happy with how everything looks, you can go over it using a black Sharpie or a black marker. This is a good opportunity to make sure that everything looks how you want it, because once you've covered it with black Sharpie, you won't be able to go back and change it. As you can see, I'm adjusting some of my hearts and lines before I go over them with black Sharpie. If my black Sharpie doesn't end up exactly where the line was, I can always go back and erase the pencil markings afterward. You may also notice that I have a thick coloring book underneath my sheet of paper. That's because black Sharpie tends to bleed through. You'll want to make sure you do something similar. Now we are going to start adding some patterns to the different sections of our work. I'm trying to copy some of the patterns that Romero Britto used in his original work, but feel free to use stars, hearts, polka dots, whatever you like. You might notice that when I get to the sections of the patterns that include parts of the hearts in them, I don't add the pattern to the hearts. You can put a different pattern in the hearts, or you can leave them solid. It's entirely up to you. There are some sections in Britto's original work that have patterns that are not made using black. I decided to copy that using crayons. You'll see in this section, I'm using a grayish silver crayon to create my pattern. And And in this section, I'm creating a pattern using a peach colored crayon. In the original work, Britto added daisy-like flowers to this side of the heart. I am doing something similar. I'm going to draw them first using a pencil so that I make sure they look more or less how I want them to. And then I can go back over them using a black Sharpie. In the middle section of the heart, Britto used diagonal striped lines. I am doing the same. There is still the little teeny tiny section at the end. That part I will leave one solid color. Now it's time to color. I'm trying to use colors that are similar to the original, but feel free to do whatever kind of coloring you want. Britto is known for his use of very bright colors. In the beginning, he focused mostly on primary colors, but now he has a company that makes all of his original colors for him. Try to use lots of bright colors, just like Romero Britto. As you can see, I colored some of the hearts one solid color. Others have patterns in the entire heart. And others still have patterns on one side of the heart and a solid color on the other. I tried to go as close to what Romero Britto did in his artwork, but you can do whatever you want with your hearts. When you're done coloring your work of art, don't forget to sign it so that everyone knows you made it. And here's my finished product. What does yours look like? Send us a picture. See you next time. Bye.